After an extended holiday break due to snow and frigid weather, school is back in session, a session that will be longer now in many districts to make up for so many snow days. KETV NewsWatch 7's Nichole Berlie stopped by a Millard school to see how kids and teachers are adjusting.
It's business as usual at Abbott Elementary in Millard.
What are you wanting to see on that report card?
Instead of going back to school as scheduled last Wednesday, snow and cold kept kids at home an extra 3 days. Principal Eric Shosey says it's important to get right back to work.
We've got ELO, or Essential Learner Outcome, assessments in grades 1 through 5 this semester. So I think the teachers are feeling a little anxiety about that.
The sign says school resumes on January 6th. Obviously, that didn't happen, but Millard already has snow days built into their calendar year. So at this point, the last day of school is June 2nd or later, depending on Mother Nature.
I'm just trying to play that catch-up game is what you're doing.
Fifth grade teacher Susie Burns is already prepping for a few extra days of classes.
I told the kids, I said they could add on to the day. They could just add days. So, you know, you're going to be here in June, so look, we're going to enjoy each other till June.
Burns says a few more days are worth it if it means students are okay.
I can see where the district came from. You've got to think of the safety of the student first.
In Millard, Nichole Berlie, KETV NewsWatch 7.
Of course, most area school districts have snow days built into their calendars, but at this point, many schools tell us they will still have to push back the last day of school.